Hi, this is Darman. Welcome to another Minecraft Let's Play video. In this video series, I'm showing you how to build Stampy's lovely world. And in the last video, we built the duck fling. Yes, the pretty duck fling. Here she is, all ready to go. But as usual, I've got a correction, which I'll talk about in a second, and a correction for the dunking booth game as well. So let's go over to Love Garden and introduce who is going in today. So today, Ernie and Bert. Hey, Bert and Ernie, how you guys doing? I haven't really talked to you guys recently. You're usually kind of staring at the fire. You're usually not quite so attentive over here. But yeah, I guess now that I don't zoom over here, I don't have to sneak up on you. I just kind of cut over here. So we've got Tiger, JL, and Ian72 submitted progress videos, and I'll leave links in the description of this video to have you guys go check out theirs. Thanks very much, guys. And Maria Herrera, who pointed out that I missed a couple of torches on top of the dunking booth game, so we'll be going back to address that issue. And also Danny Lee, who is already somewhere around here and has been extremely helpful over and over again with some of the details, mentioned that I did not, I missed one of the, one of these things, one of the lampposts. I missed one completely. And in fact, I did not build it in my my Stampy download seed, which is why I missed it somehow. So we'll be doing that. And yes, on today's video that came out, as of the date of this video, that is, the Love Garden has been extended yet again. I have not done it yet. You can just feel free to do it. Nothing to it. Just bring it out one more row, and this little notch should not be there. But we'll do that in an update video officially. I think I better do an update video pretty soon. What do you think? We definitely have some updates that we need to take care of. Maybe after we do this build the bunkhouse and the train, maybe this will be the time to go ahead and do some updates so that everybody can just continue on with their lovely worlds in the most update fashion possible. So, without further ado, let us go back and start making those corrections and start our build for today. All right, so let's do the lamp post that's missing right here. So it should be, let's see, if we go right from this corner, we're going to go to the fourth one to the left. One, two, three, four. So there should be three in between here. And again, this is just a standard lamp. One, two, wait, that was three, four, five. Come on, five. Hey, by the way, a lot of people told me, and it's true, that this whole zooming problem is over. You know, the zoom has been defeated, as it was on the flash. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay, yeah. So thank goodness that is over. Let's just hope something like that, horrible like that, doesn't happen anymore. And thank you very much for whoever fixed that over there at the studios. Hopefully. I'm sure it was us complaining that got it fixed, right? It was us. I'm sure it was completely ours. It had nothing to do with actual famous YouTubers complaining to them. They probably realized the second it happened. So anyway, all right. So look, we've got two little lamps here. We've got a tree. If we kind of squint and look in this direction, it almost looks like Stampy's Funland. Okay, so. And to make it look more like Stampy's Funland, we're going to do some, we're going to block out some terrain today. And right here, and I'm going to kind of switch my view over to my Stampy download seed for a second here. Right here, you see, this is like what we're going for. And there's the blue diamond, of course, that's not going to stay. But the blue diamond is outlining what we're building. So we're building this kind of chunk of land today. That's the plan. So back here in the real world, we're left with this here. So that's just going to, this has to go. Now, especially this sheep, because this sheep has been here, I don't know how long, but ever since I started building that thing, I noticed that he's been standing right here on the edge, just too afraid to jump. So I'm going to encourage you to just move out of there, buddy, because I hope you're not, okay, he's okay. He's totally fine with that. Because what we're going to do is we're actually going to kind of start here, because this is where the land is going to connect that we're going to build. And don't be afraid. It's not really big. It's not, all right, it's not small, but it's doable. I hope it's doable in one video. Might be a long video. I'm not going to lie to you. All right, so and what we're going to do is we're going to build We're going to build the top level of what we're going to build is going to be where the bunkhouse sits. And over here, there's going to be, there really is more on top, but he was kind of talking about flattening that out. So I don't know how much we want to deal with that right now. And there, you know, Harry's house is there right now, but that's not necessarily permanent. So what we're going to do is we're going to start right here. We're going to go to the, let's see, the third, where the third block is here. We're going to start right next to it. We're going to build up three from here. And then we're gonna make a big rectangle and then add details. Well, I don't know how many details. We're gonna build the top level first, and then we're gonna build walls and add details on the side, which is it's fairly normal how we usually do it. So, all right. So we built it up three here. Now this is gonna go in this direction 18. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So we're going to build a big rectangle. So this way, we're going to go 27 this way. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then we just need to make these corners meet up. And if nothing else, you can build this top part, you know, not just the square. Wait a minute. Hold on. Let me make sure this meets up correctly. You can build this top part and the extra bits we're going to put on the edges of it. And you could build the bunkhouse on top of this. And wow, I actually did that right. You can build the bunkhouse on top of this and make up any sort of terrain you want as long as it doesn't interfere with anything else, which... there's nothing else over here except for the tree train, which is way over here. So you should have no problems accomplishing that. So let's go ahead and fill that in with grass. Okay, and right over here, there's this little piece of dirt that's coming down here. And this is really just to illustrate something. This is just brings that corner straight down. So right from here, if you drew a line all the way from there to, don't draw a line, but just to count the blocks, between there and there should be 21 blocks of grass here. The 22nd block you should hit your path here, unless you haven't extended it this far. If you haven't, go ahead and extend it at least this far. You don't need to go any real farther if you don't want to, because we're going to eventually do more terrain over here, and you know obviously the path is here. But I kind of went over the dimensions of the path in this area at least before. So yeah, so that should be 21, you know, between there and over there. So let's get to work on the details. Now this side is going to stay flat over here. It's going to look silly. This is going to be like a big giant chopped it off with an axe. We'll do that terrain over there at some other point. I just wanted to kind of get a chunk of it so that we could, you know, get to work on this. So well, this is good, Lisa. We'll be starting to tie in the town to the Funland a little bit, just as he has done. So we're gonna start right here, and we are going to add on a piece that is 15 blocks long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Yep, and that leaves three there. The next row is going to be one shorter than that, so we'll just go one shorter, and it comes all the way back to the same spot. All these rows are going to start in the same spot, because again, the big giant axe of the giant came here and chopped this off for now. So this one is going to be 7 blocks long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go back over here. And this one is 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it's one shorter, obviously. And the next two, there's two rows of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. I can't even count to 5. Oh, well. Two rows of 5, and it looks like that. Okay, so that's that part over there. And now on the front part... actually, we're going to start on this side. It might be a little easier to explain. Starting on this corner, we're going to skip the first one and then bring this all the way across to where this one stops, you know, even with that one. And let's go back over here. Oh, this zooming is working good again. This is good. So we're going to go again, one shorter here, bring this all the way across. So that's the first two rows. Now the next one we can start here. We're going to skip this first one, and then we're going to go all the way across, but one shorter on this side. So it kind of makes this starting to make this angle here. And again, one more, However, this one only goes 12 blocks. So we're going to start here. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And there we go. So we should have a total of, let's see here. We've got this corner here. We should have 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we're going to add the fifth one here. And this one is, again, starts diagonally there and is going to be, it's going to come two blocks short of this end here. And then we're going to add, skip that first block there. We're going to add 2 blocks here, and then we're going to skip 3. And then we're going to add 2 here and 2 here and come out and add 2 more. So there should be, you know, once you've gotten past this corner, it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 corners. And then it comes out to this. It goes in here. There's 3 here and so forth over here. So this should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And there we go. That is effectively the top portion. And you can build the bunkhouse on top of this. So it's no problem. And I would not fill any of this in. Not that you probably were inclined to do so. Or you may be building on a world that is not flat here. But either way, you're going to need to dig out a basement under the bunkhouse anyway. It's going to be like 4 blocks deep, I think, something like that. I'll have to double check that. But anyway, so with this, let's build walls all the way straight down from here. And now let's get to work on the front. We're going to start right here in this corner here. Right here in this corner here. Wow, just use the same word over and over again, Darman. That's just great. We're going to start here 1 block down, and we're going to add 1 here, and we're going to bring 1 row straight across until we bump into this thing. And then we're going to back it up, and on the second one to the left of that, we're just going to drag that straight across. Again here, skip the first 2, and bring that across. So that should be 3 long there. And right, since we're here, we're going to just pull that right across, straight across to it, right to there. And so the next one will be easier to do then. So we're going to skip just 1 on the end and bring that straight across to there. And again, 1 more time, 1 straight across to there. Now, we're going to bring this out 1 more, in 1 more again from that end. And we're going to bring it out right to the middle of this guy. This one goes 1 block beyond it like this. That's all right. Just leave it hanging out there for a minute. It'll look better later. Make a lot more sense. And then we're going to start in the same spot here and make it 1 block shorter on that end. And then we're going to go skip 1 block, and we're going to make it 1 block shorter on that end. So now we've kind of made the first little step down from up there. This is maybe a little bit different than I've done terrains. Usually I just kind of say, you know, how many, you know, blocks of dirt you have to put down in a column, and we will do that kind of in the other side, but this side has little bigger steps, so I think this is probably a little easier to do. So remember this thing over here? Well, just bring that straight back now. There you go. That is looking good now. And you know what? I've mentioned this in every time I do terrain videos. This doesn't have to be perfect. Not at all. You do whatever you want. You just, as long as you can, put the clubhouse wherever it is that you want. The clubhouse, I guess that's the clubhouse over there. The bunkhouse, what I call it. You make it your own if you want. It doesn't have to be exact. This is just a starting point. And I say that mostly because in case I screw up the terrain, I don't feel too bad about it. How about that? No, that's terrible. Okay, so for right here, we're going to start 1 block back here and bring it straight back all the way to there. And then we're going to start at the same spot, bring it all the way back. And then here we're going to skip 2 and bring it all the way back. Then to skip 1, bring that all the way back to here. Then skip 2, and that should bring us right to there. Okay, yep, perfect. All right, so that is everything at that level on this side. I should have probably mentioned, we're going to do like the front part here, and then we'll do the side over there. Just kind of divide it up that way. That one is really more the traditional way that I do it, put 3 blocks here, 2 blocks here, 1 block here, 2 blocks here, 3 blocks, So anyway, so now I think the best thing to do is to continue our practice of putting a wall down, because it makes it easier to build larger pieces like this, I think. At least that's the way I do it. So let's add walls to this. And wow, my helper even put a pig down there. Now it just sort of appeared. All right, so we're going to start again at this spot here, this edge here. So we've already done the top level, which, by the way, should be 7 blocks high. I probably should have mentioned that. So we just did the 6th block level over here. We're going to do the 5th block high level right now. So we're going to go right here and go 1 block down, obviously, because we need to go to the next level, and just drag that straight across. And then on this end, we're just going to add 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 right there. And then we're going to go right over here into this corner here. We're going to put just 1. Leave that one alone. And then we're going to put this little, we're going to put 1 here, 1 in front of that, and 1 to the right of that one. And then here we're going to put 1 here, 1 in front of it, 1 to the left of that one, 1 in front of that, and then connect it right to that one. And then from here we're going to go all the way across, and then we're going to extend it 2 blocks. Yeah, 2 blocks, 1, 2. And we're going to put another row exactly like it right in front of it. And now we can just connect this straight back like that. Now we're going to skip the first 2 here. Bring that all the way back. Skip that one again. Bring that back. And we're going to start in the same spot here and just bring that straight back. I'm going to skip these first 2. Bring that back. Again, skip the first one. No, just skip 1. Skip the first 1. And then bring that there. And then we should be, there we go. We should be already there. We're getting there. We are getting there. So let's just, let's add the walls in front of this one. We'll see where the pig ends up this time. And now we can go over here and begin the 4th block level. So let's go down 1. And we're going to take, actually, let's start in this little nook here. We're just going to, 1 lower, we're just going to fill that in. And the same thing, we're going to fill this all the way across to here. And here we're going to add 1, 2, 3 on the end there. Skip this one. And then bring this straight across to meet up with that. And we're going to start again right at this piece right here. And bring it all the way across and make it fill in that little gap there. Here we go. And starting here, we're going to skip the first 3. Hello, piggy. 1, 2, 3. Did I guess count that? I get distracted by my little animals. Let's bring that straight across here. And we're going to skip this 3. Yeah, 1, 2, 3 here. And bring that across to there. And then we're just going to skip 1 this time. And bring that across. I keep saying bring that across, bring that across. Sorry, it's just repetitive, I know, but all right, so we're going to skip that one. And okay, so from this point, we're going to add 1 here, and we're going to go over and go 1 block longer on this side. Okay, and that's it on the front for that part. And we should now be getting pretty close here to the path. We should be within like 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yep, that's right. Okay, so over here, obviously we'll fill this in here. And we'll skip that one. Skip the first one again. Skip that one yet again. And yet again, one more time. Straight across there. There we go. All right, so that is how that should look at this point. And again, no, not to be perfect, but it's just got it. You don't want to slope it too much, because then you're going to end up on top of the path. So whatever you can do to make that happen, that works for me. So let's bring the walls down for that one. All right, now time for level number 3. All right, again, we're going to start here. I'm going to put 1 block in this little niche that's already there. We're going to just fill that in there. And here, start all the way on the left, fill that. Again, one more time on the left, fill that all the way across. Start here, and then this one actually goes 1 more block in this direction. I would have normally cut it off, but I just didn't want to forget it. So we're going to leave it sitting out there, and we'll eventually, that'll make a little bit more sense in just a little bit. So yeah, so that'd be 1, 2, 3, the 4th row out. It's going to stick out just that little bit for now. And this next one, we're going to start lining up right with here. That's just the easier way. Pig, you are about to be trapped in there for all eternity, okay, until you despawn, which you probably wouldn't, because it's such a small space. So you can decide for yourself whether you want to be alone in the dark down there, or come out here and enjoy. It's a nice good piggy life out here. Okay, so let's see. Now here we're going to skip these two, and we're going to bring it across. I can't stop saying it. Okay, so that's even with this now. Okay, good. All right, so that's that piece, and we're going to... there's nothing that goes in front of this that's at the third level. So then we're going to go just a little bit over here. Let's see here. We're going to bring it... Let's do it this way. We're going to put one in each little corner like that. We're going to add two more in these little corners. And then two more with one there, and then one right there. Okay, there it is. And the pig has decided to live. Yay, piggy. Good for you, buddy. Always choose life. Okay, so let's just fill those little bits in there. And now on to the second. We're down to level number two here. So we're almost done this side. Right, so here, remember how we bumped this out one piece? Well, we're actually going to do it here again. We're actually going to go out one farther here. And then bring us all the way. Piggy, almost the same problem. All right, and then here, going to bring us all the way out to that same spot. And I will let you talk to my magic helper that helps me fill in these walls. I don't think I need much help in that regard right now. Yeah, you know what we'll do? We'll just, we're going to do this the first level over here because it's here and it's just, one little bit. So I'm just going to go ahead and fill this in. And I'm going to have to boot you out of here, buddy. Just scoot on out of here. I'm just going to give you a little tap. No, you did not go in the only hole there. Get out of here. Get. I will swat your little tushy. Get. Thank you. Get out of... Do you see that? The only hole there. And he's like, oh, I'm going to go hide in here. Not a smart move, buddy. Okay, so then we're going to start right here. Lined up with kind of like where we started, that big piece of terrain here. So it's two blocks away from here. And this is going to be 10 blocks long. 1, 2, 3, 4, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yep, so it should be just right past that part right there. Okay, so now we're down to, there's nothing here for five blocks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then what we'll do is we'll do it this way. Oh, now I just lost my place. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So then on the sixth one, we're going to put a row going all the way across to all the way to the edge. And we can, right in this hole, we can put two there. Over here, another two. Oop, another two. There we go. Okay, and then right on top of here, we're going to skip these first three. And we're going to put two all the way over, except we're going to leave these two alone there. And that's... those two, and there we go. Then we just have one more row. This is it. Ready? All right, so skip these first two, put it right here in front, but skip that last one right there. Oh, and actually we need this right here, that is a block of sand. There's more sand going this way, but I think this must be the first block that we encounter. There's probably sand under here too, but you want to put it in there and knock yourself at, wow, that sand did not fall. Okay, now I must not have given it enough time. Okay, so that, from here over, this is it. This is the terrain, people. So that's good. So even if you only did this and then just kind of, futzed around and, did whatever on this side, still, I think you're going to have an awesome result. So, all right, so let's do this, people. And we're gonna get this done in one video. We are going to do this. No problemo. I'm so excited about getting this, and then we can get the bunkhouse done. And yeah, there's some note blocks under there. You know that, right? And it plays a song. It plays like the beginning of the Mario song. That do 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 do. Except it's a little off. But we're gonna give you an option to fix it up a little bit. All right. So up here, we're gonna do a little bit. Like we just did there, we got a couple of levels over here we can do that way, and then we're going to get into the real nitty gritty stuff here. So at this point, though, we're going to be working at the sixth block level. And let's see, where are we going to start this? Right over here. Nope, past these two. And anybody see that? I just did that. Well, it didn't do it as bad anyway. That's the first time it's happened, so there's definitely been an improvement in the mechanics. Right here, we want to put, let's see, this is a total of 5 blocks long. Yeah, the first three, let's go down a level. 3 should be at this level, and we're going to leave these two alone. They're going to be down a lower level. So those 3, and then we're going to put 2 here. We'll put 1 here and bring it across, bring it all the way back to there. Bring it 1 back from here and just add 3 here, skip 2, and then finish that up there. And here it's going to come up 1 short here, put that in, another short one right there. Here we're going to come out, same place, we're going to start right there, bring that back, and we're going to put another one just like it, but leave that one block short like that. So that's the 6th block level here. And that's it. There doesn't go any farther because we're just kind of sloping down at this point. All right, so let's put some wall up here. And let's start the 5th block level. And by the way, I should have mentioned, if you're working off of Stampy Seed World, and, this is basically, you don't really need to fix much if you don't really feel like fixing much of anything. But there are some changes. Just know that there are some, but... you know, if you don't want to have to be super, super, super exact, then don't worry about it. I think you're good to go. Mostly, you'll just have to level out. There'll be extra terrain up here you'll have to get rid of in order to make room for your bunkhouse. If I recall correctly, that's probably the biggest change you'll have to make in order to do that. But anyway, so we are now at the 5th block level. Here we go. Let's see, how do we want to... Let's start on this end. I think this will be easier. Yeah, let's start right over here where we started the 6th block level. Here we're going to go down here, we're going to add 2 at the 5th block level, and then don't connect it, but then just put 2 here, come out and put 2 more, and again 2 more right there. Then at this point, let's see, right over here, let's put 2 in there, that way we can put this starting right here all the way over. And see, I didn't say across, I said over. See, I can change. let's see, go great. Now I did all that and I just lost my place. You guys are like, come on, let's get going on this. Stop talking. Let's see, so we're just going to skip these 3 and then bring that back. And we're just going to skip 1 and another one there. And then attaching right here, I'm going to bring it all the way back to the part that gets chopped off. And again, one more time, the exact same thing. Then we're going to skip that one and do this row. And again, repeat that row one more time like that. And that's it. Looks good. Let's put a wall on that. Okay. And, while I was just filling that in, I just realized that I never did put the the correction that was given to me by Maria Herrera. I got the torches right here in my hand. I'm going to take a quick break, go right over here, and you probably already guys figured out there should be torches here and here, which makes sense because there's not really much in the way of light. Look at this, I've captured a kitty. Hello, kitty, you have apparently wandered a bit too close to the minecart. Are you enjoying your little ride? I'm going to go back and forth with you. I don't know, he sort of looks like he's having fun, but he also looks like he might want to escape. Well, you enjoy the ride. That's fun when you capture like mobs. If I had googlies turned on, eventually I guarantee there'd be somebody in there. I have caught both creepers and endermen actually in traps like that by accident in the Stampy's. What is it? In the secret base when I was building that originally, had like mine carts whizzing around underneath, and periodically I'd come down there and I'd see a creeper whizzing around a little cart. That was hilarious. And but anyway, so all right, so we're getting there. This side is looking a little hollow. That's okay, that's just fine, no problem. If you want, you can extend, I don't know if I want to tell you to extend this all the way over to here. That's not going to meet up with this, but you could, if you wanted, like at this level, bring it all the way out to here and then just sort of put some more terrain just to kind of make it. I'm just worried that he's going to flatten this out and you're going to do a lot of work and then end up having to flatten it out. So we're going to probably hold off on that. All right. So We are at the fourth block level. Okay, and let's see. We're going to go right over here. We're going to put ones there. Okay, and then here. And go out here, over this way, back and over, back and over. Put two right there like that. It should be even with that level. And we just have to put one right in the corner. And this is kind of getting into the nitty-gritties, which I usually just kind of call out the numbers. So, but we'll finish this fourth level, and then we'll do the first, second, and third in kind of the more traditional way here. There should be one here. Here and here going across, and then one right here, looks like. All right, we'll see how that goes. All right, so that's that. Do I need to build a wall for this now? Because we're just going to be building straight up at this point. We're going to, if you're not familiar with my terrain videos, this is what we're going to do. Right here, in this empty spot, I'm going to say things like three, and you're going to put down one, two, three. And this one, this is actually three going straight across. You know, I'm going to bring this right across to this corner here, because that's otherwise I'd be wasting a lot of time seeing threes all over the place. So let's see, right here, this is two, and I guess we are going to have to fill this in a bit. Yeah, I'm not going to worry too much about it. Anything I see that I need to fill in. I think I will. All right, so I won't worry about that. So this is two, another two, and a one here. And speaking of one, there's one last row of ones right over here. That go start at the back and go right to that first two, right in line with that. And the second two is, there's nothing there. So this is flat ground here. And there we go. That's there. That's that side right there. Done. All right. Let's get in here. Should have two columns of three. Come back, put another column of three, another column of three here, and one more in front of that one. And we're going to go into this corner here, put three there. This corner gets three, and again, we're going to come out three here and put three right in that corner. And one in one column of three in front of that one. Oops, three column of three right here. One in front of that one. And one right here in front of this. This is where we are right now. That's that one. It's got a couple of more here that it threw at the third level. Yeah, let's put one more comma three in front of that one. All right, something's starting to look funky on my map here. Yeah, something here. Let's see. This is five, five, four, three. This should be two. Okay, there we go. And then zero here. All right, so then this one is, so you've already got five, five, four, and this one is three, two here, and that's it for there. Let's fill that in there. All right, so then, okay, so this one should be three here and two there. And so this one is, should have five, five, four, let's fill that in, three, three, two. And then right here, we're going to fill this across with ones. And same thing here, we can get one under there. And drag this across. There's ones all the way over to there. And that's it. We just have to put a few little bits under here. I'm going to cover that up because you're going to see that. All right. So over here, the ones continue around here. There's one. Okay. So this is three. So there should be two there. And then one there. And then we got two here. One here. Two here. One here, two here, one here, and let me see, I might be a little bit lost to my map. Oh, we're going to add one more here, and right here we're going to have two here, two here, one there, two there, one here. Yeah, I got to pull up to see where I'm at here on this Oh, yep. I need one more here. Put two here. Actually, two go here. There should be a third one. Three right there. Yep. Yep. That's right. Again, these are the tiniest of details, which I don't think are really all that necessary to follow. At this point, you can just put... Actually, that's it. That's it. There's not one, you know, a little one block. So you can put them there if you so choose. But yeah, there we go. All right. We did it. We did it in one video. All right. So we've got a big chunk of terrain here, which is basically correct. Well, basically, it really is, you know, accurate to his world. I've gone to a lot of trouble to make it so. But this is terrain. And Stampy warned me, you know, terrain is fluid. It is meant to be changed. It is not meant to be necessarily static. So, be that as it may, we have done this. If something changes, if the bunkhouse gets wiped off the face of the earth, then we will have to change it. That's all. We will just roll the punches because change is what it's all about. Now, he does have kind of snow sprinkled about. Not really on the top here, but there's like a lot of snow on the sides. And at this point, if you really didn't, you know, want to get too nuts about the terrain, making it perfect, what you could do is actually see how it steps down and down and down. You could actually bring that basically all the way back to, you know, as far as you want, you know, maybe kind of into this area, because this is like where he's going to probably build his entrance, or I don't know. I don't know really what he's going to. His plans, I don't know if they've been solidified even in his own mind, but, you know, you could extend that back if you want, or personally, I'm not going to do it right now because I really don't know what he's going to do back there. So the sign is not moving, so that's why that is there, and this will be, that's a nice bit of terrain, and he complained that he didn't like that his Funland was so flat, which is why nowadays he's got areas where he's raised up. And is building, you know, in those areas, and that's on purpose for like that. All right, so we have done this. We've made our corrections. We've got our extra lamp. We've got our extra torches up there. Thanks, people, for chiming in on that. And generally, I don't get any comments about the terrain videos, as people don't really have much to say about what I did or didn't do. But yeah, we will be adding on to this because this looks a little silly over here right now. But at least we've got something. If you know. Some people have already gone ahead and built the terrain over here based on videos like from when he built the pizza parlor to, you know, you could, you know, bring this straight across, which probably should have done. I probably should have filled all that in. That's all right. I'll do that some other time. And, you know, from here, you know, we can do this terrain and then all of this down here and kind of really carve that out and make this look really nice at some point. In the future, but I like to take a break between the terrain videos because it gets to be a little much. So this will do for now, big enough to get our bunkhouse on. So in the next video, that's exactly what we're going to be doing. And yeah, so let's get to it. So I am Darman68. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.